Thank you. While the glue is drying, I want to talk about these marble lanes because they're special. So first of all, these grooves are a 90 degree square. So the marble always have a contact point on a 90 degree angle. And most of all, the walls are tilted. So this wall is angled inside. And when the marble comes down here, this wall is angled the other way. So here is angled like this, and then it's come around, angled like that. Like a roller coaster. So this keeps the marble in the lane and it can't skip a step. Twist is good, but it's too long. No, what did I do? What did I do? When did I stop looking at my template? I spent 4 days cutting this. Okay, I can fix it. I named the CAD file Perfection Exists. It was a lie. How cool does this look though? Oh, this twist is great. That looks cool. Yeah. So I made this oversized here so I can fit this perfectly here. So I'm gonna remove what I don't need. And I need to make it shorter here. I think I can do that without too much shame, actually. Yeah, kind of a lot of shame, actually, Martin. I came so close to making something amazingly perfect and I just overshot. I just forgot to look at my template in the end. Because look, this is my template and my thing is 30 centimeters longer. I just started to think about these slanted marble tracks. By the way, I would actually like to learn how to do this better in CAD. I think we can maybe learn together. I was so hyper focused on this roller coaster angled marble tracks to get that right in CAD. So I just lost track of the big picture down here. I'm going to modify this a little bit and fit it properly. So I need to actually do that tomorrow with a fresh mind. The CNC machine took like 9 hours to get rid of all the burr. So that tilted my day a little bit today. I really hate to end the video without a really nice payoff in a huge disaster. I really like threw down the design gauntlet on this one and... Oh, it's so typical me. How can I be so uneven? Like... So you can see this, like, I think this is like super nice, really understanding of plywood and CAD. And like, I'm showing off a lot of skill and understanding and make it 30 centimeters too long. I shouldn't have named the CAD file Perfection Exists. That bit me. Okay, one more marble. Oh, that's nice. Here comes some more. What can I say? Okay, so I just wanted to ask if someone who is great with this have an idea for how to make these tilted marble lanes simpler. So I just want to show you how I built this up. So first of all, it's all built up with lofts. The lofts are following center lines. These are the center lines the loft is following. And then we see my tilted sketches. So here you can see here's all my tilts
Let's go into this sketch. You can kind of see that I have this angle constraint here. It says 40 degrees there. So I can change that to 30 and everything just follows. So that means that on this part of the marble lane, the angle of the square which the marble will ride in is 40 degrees or 30. If you have a simpler way to express these geometries in Fusion 360, it would be great if you could leave an idea on the Discord server. I tried a lot of different things. What I'll do is that I export my CAD file and I'll link it under this video if you want to look at all my horrible timelines. I'm not practicing what I'm preaching. Also good for the MMX CAD team. Then you have this design and yeah, it's kind of horrible in a way. So here's my versions. I have A New Hope Again, A New Hope Again 2. Then I have 3 copies of A New Hope Again 3. And I ended up with A New Hope Again 5, and that was wrong. I can just show you what I did on the version before. So this is a completely different CAD design, a completely different idea. And this is from the time where I still looked at my beautiful template, because it's actually going out where it should, the last lane. good, Martin. So what I did here is that you can see these. They look kind of ugly, but I made all round shapes with the lofts. So let's see if we can see the sketches. So here you can see, instead of using the square, I used these round shapes. But when you loft between them, it's not always natural how the loft acts. So especially if you see here, this is ugly. This is so small, so on the CNC machine you wouldn't have seen it. But that's a kind of another idea on the same theme. Wilson remains happy. Come rain, come shine. What we're looking for is a way to build this up that is easy to modify. Okay, I want a little more angle. I want to switch the lane over to here. I want to make the lane wider. We want to do that very from the top view in a nice parametric design. I don't really know how to do that. This is just for us all to learn. If you have any suggestions, post them in the Idea Vault on the Discord server and I'll look at them very soon. So that will be awesome. Okay, thanks so much.